hello and welcome. Thank you for letting us share a part of your day. And we have a busy time ahead. But first of all, I want to introduce Charles Dietrich. And Charles is here. He owns something called Pet Haven, right?
Yes.
And he brought this Blue. Nice dog.
That's Blue.
And I tell you, that's one of the best mannered little creatures I've ever seen. He's been sitting here in the studio so patiently. Yeah. Tell me the truth, Charles. What is Pet Haven?
Pet Haven's a nonprofit. We have a 501c3 with the government, and we rescue homeless cats and dogs off the streets. Our primarily is chained up animals, feral cats, adopting kittens and dogs. We do well over 100 a year.
And in the meantime, you feed and try to care for these little creatures that
yes.
ordinarily would be just
outside.
Destroyed.
Yeah, or hit by a car.
Yeah. So how did you get into all of this, Charles? What brought all this about?
I lived in a condominium when I came down here in 1996. I lived over in Malden Woodwinds condos,
yeah.
And there was about 20 cats. And I asked this lady to help me. She ran CCA Feral Cat Colony, Kathy Hess, and she trained us how to trap and get animals to the vet and stuff like that, and how to cover them up, how to make them relax. And she's trained a lot of people around here. But anyway, I got saved in 1996, December, and I just opened up my eyes, and there's homeless animals all over the place. So I just love homeless animals.
And do you need help?
Oh, yeah. I think this is a community project. We're always looking for volunteers. So far, we don't have any, but we have, there's about six of us. They're all on payroll. And we trap, neuter, release, and the adults.
So you take these animals and try to find homes for them.
Yes.
And in the meantime, you provide medical care and food and whatever they need.
Yes. We shampoo them and we get the fleas and the worms out of them. And he was heartworm positive, so we spent a lot of money on him.
Yeah, he's ready to be adopted?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's microchipped. His nails are cut.
Oh, he likes watching himself on television. So, Pet Haven, you need help. You need people to know about you, and you need volunteers. And I have the phone number here, 350-3735. Is that right?
Yes, and we have a website, scpethaven.org.
I think he's going to go out. Wait a minute. Wait. If you're mic'd, you can't. Okay, come on over here with me. He's not terribly happy with being on television. No, but you need other people to help you. And if somebody out there has an animal they can't take care of, they can call you?
Hopefully not. We primarily do homeless animals.
Okay, so you try to find a home for an animal that's just wandering around?
Yeah, we pretty much do homeless animals. I did something like this on Channel 4, and people called my phone number for a year straight. Please take my puppy. Please take my cat.
Uh-huh.
And I tried my best to do that, but it's bigger than me. This is a community project. The Humane Societies, both of them in Spartanburg, Greenville, they're backed up 2-3 months.
I know they are, and they do a wonderful job.
And yeah, and they can't do anymore. Animal care, there's a bunch of people that do what I do, and some of them have a lot more than I have, and some of them have a lot less, but it's a money thing. It's, you know, it's how much, how big is your, how many pets could you afford to take
to
the vet?
So right now, let's see, you have, you've given me a list here. You've got some other people that are involved.
I have, we have three big projects we're doing. One is Melissa Lee. She's in 124 Calico Lane, Easley.
Yeah.
And we've trapped and took care of those animals. They're not her animals. It's a bad area in Easley.
They just appear.
Yeah, it's Dacresfield. So it's really north of Berea, just a little bit. And she cares for them. She feeds them. So we help her out with some food donations. And we spayed and neutered everybody on the property. And I just picked up two kittens from there this morning. There's another lady, she's 75, Addie. She's on 1354 Pissin Farm Road, Belton, 29627.
Yeah.
She has 40 cats that don't belong to her. So I got three kittens, medical care, and I trapped and neutered 7 to 8 adults and put them back. She's feeding them. And then there's a big project up in Woodruff we're doing. There's only 3 cats left, but I've gotten 20 kittens from there. 10 female adults and 5 male adults. And I met all their medical needs and brought them back. Now, Ginger, she's feeding those cats up there.
Okay.
So we brought her some food.
So you need people to donate some food and things like that if they want to.
Or their time for transportation. There's a lot of transportation, like pick up and drop off at the veterinarian.
I don't think he's very happy. Look, come here. Come on, Papa.
Come here, Blue. Come here.
But look, if you want to hear from people, I have the number here. And if you want to get involved and help homeless animals, whether it's contributions with puppy food, dog food, whatever, or if they want to call you, it's all right.
Yeah, we can give them a tax-free donation, too, if they want. We can,
All right. Charles Dietrich, who started something called Pet Haven. And you're located once more where?
28 Scarlet Street, Greenville, right near McAllister Square.
So you're right in Greenville.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going to come see you.
Okay.
Okay. I'm an animal lover. And I think it's painful to see any animal that isn't cared for.
We have a lot of cats.
Thank you for what you're doing.
Many kittens up for adoption. Okay. And some dogs, too.
Okay. All right. I'll be over there. I promise you.
Thank you.
Thank you
Thanks
very
for having
much.
Me.
Thank you. Charles Dietrich, Pet Haven. We'll be right back.